One of the most popular yet also most hated vehicle versions video of all time was the video I filmed about the 6 reasons why I hate the 2006 Ford GT. Now, I don't actually hate the car. I love it. It's one of the best cars I've ever driven. But there are some problems with it. Many people on the forums agreed, owners of Ford GTs, and other people just thought I was an asshole. So without further ado, we're going to talk about the 6 reasons I hate the new Ford GT right at the booth in front of a bunch of Ford executives. I hope I don't die. First off, Ford lied about the specs on the Ford GT. The chief performance engineer said that they are going to have the best power to weight ratio of any car on the road. Well, unfortunately, the math doesn't really work out on that. Take the Bugatti Chiron, for instance. Its power to weight ratio is 683 horsepower per ton. Now, it's very possible that the Ford GT might have 683 horsepower, but to have that power to weight ratio, that means it would have to have a weight of under 2,000 pounds. That is legitimately impossible for a vehicle of this size. It gets even worse compared to something like a Koenigsegg 1-to-1 with over 890 horsepower per ton. You get the point, there's no way that it can be the best power to weight ratio. And they didn't just say in its class, they said of any car. Second up, it's too exclusive and they did so in the wrong way. Limited to just 1,000 units, that's more exclusive than the Ferrari LaFerrari, which has 706 units, including the Aperta, and the Porsche 918, which of course has 918 units. The issue is, they were trying to limit the production to boost the hype, to make it as cool and as desired as the 2006 Ford GT is right now. But they made 4,000 of those, and they only became cool after they started exploding in recent times. The problem is, that left a bunch of people who owned the previous generation Ford GT, even owned a GT40, without the ability to buy one. And they ended up in the hands of random Minecraft YouTubers or famous Instagrammers. I don't know exactly how they picked their candidates. There was probably some blindfolded dart throwing. There's a lot of people who deserve to get them who are diehard Ford fans who didn't end up with them.
All of the buttons in the interior feel and look cheap. Remember, this is a $450,000 car, and Ford is trying to step away from the notion of, oh yeah, but it's still a Ford. And in order to do that, they've got to raise the benchmark on all levels. Now, I understand this is all about saving weight, but look at something like the McLaren 675 LT, for instance. That's extremely lightweight, uses tons of carbon fiber, Alcantara, and still looks beautiful inside. The seats in the Ford GT are insanely close together. It is the most intimate seating experience I have ever seen in a car of any kind. If you are going out on your first date, then maybe it might be great because you're rubbing up against a girl all the time, but if you're just hanging out with your friend, then you're gonna be bumping elbows the entire ride and potentially end up hitting each other.
Next is the engine. Yes, there are many reasons why the new Ford GT has the EcoBoost V6, but supercar owners expect a certain sex appeal that comes with a V8, a V10, or a V12 engine. Imagine if the new Aventador SV came out and it had a 6-cylinder engine. That would be sacrilegious. What would have truly made this car insane is if they put the twin turbocharged V8 that's likely going to power the new GT500, turned it up a notch, stuck it in the middle of this Ford GT. That would have been epic. Lastly, the EcoBoost doesn't really hold up to its name. It's supposed to be a lightweight, environmentally friendly, powerful engine. But the EPA has a different thing to say about it. The results are in, and the fuel efficiency is 11 miles per gallon city and 18 on the highway. Let's compare that, for instance. That's worse than a Huracan, which is naturally aspirated. It's worse than a 675 LT, worse than an Audi R8, worse than a Nissan GT-R. That's not really the EcoBoost you're used to hearing in the marketing world. Now, if you buy a supercar, do you care at all about the fuel economy? Absolutely not. But if Ford is going to tout that the EcoBoost is their environmentally friendly engine that's offered in every single one of their cars, they better have the stats to back it up. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like always, please browse our channel and subscribe. Look forward to seeing you next video.